Welcome to another programming video tutorial. Swift language has a variety of built-in protocols implemented, some of which are used more often than others. For example, we use the Equatable and Decodable protocols more frequently than the Hashable protocol. When writing programs in Swift, then unavoidably you will come to the need of a particular protocol at some point, which is the Equatable protocol. But what exactly is it, and when do we need it? The Equatable protocol makes it easy to compare instances of two types and decide if they can be considered equal or not. Basic types in Swift, such as integers, strings, and so on, already conform to it. It also enables us to determine if a particular instance is contained in a collection, and I will talk more about that in a while. The moment that we actually need to manually adopt it and implement its requirements comes when we have to compare instances of custom types. See for example the car type over here. It's a struct with three properties that store the model, year, and color of a car. Let's define the two car instances now, providing different values for each car. Now, let's add this simple condition. Depending on whether the two car instances are equal or not, the respective message will be printed to the console. However, Xcode is showing an error now. It says that the binary operator equal to cannot be applied to two car operands. In different words, this message is simply saying that these two instances cannot be compared for equality. They are of the custom type, and the compiler does not know how to do that. To fix things and make the message go away, it's necessary to adopt the Equatable protocol in the car type. That small addition is good enough in order to make the compiler capable of comparing two car instances. In fact, I can now run my small code and find out that the two cars are different indeed. Now, here is an interesting detail. The car type is a struct and the compiler synthesizes the equal to operator automatically under the hood. That's not the case though when the custom type is a class, or, and that's important, if stored properties in the struct do not conform already to Equatable. To demonstrate what I'm talking about, let me change the car from being a struct into a class. In addition, it's mandatory to add an initializer as it's not synthesized automatically either. You can see that a new error is popping out right after that change, saying that the car type does not conform to Equatable protocol. Xcode is suggesting a fix. To add the missing protocol steps. By clicking on it, a method to implement the equal to operator is added to our class. That's the place now to describe programmatically when two car instances are considered equal or not. This is going to be true when values of all three properties are the same for both parameters, the left hand and right hand side car objects. The code is compiling without problems again now. Besides equality, we can also check if two instances of a type conforming to Equatable are not equal. This print statement will print true, which is the result of the expression's evaluation. Next, let's define an array with a few random cars. Our purpose here is to find out if car1 and car2 instances exist in that array or not. Programmatically, we'll use the contains method in the array and will print the proper message depending on the method's return value. See that this code is running just fine once again, and the output is letting us know that the first car exists in the cars collection, while the second does not. Searching the cars array using the contains method is possible thanks to a Equatable protocol that allows the given car object in both occurrences to be compared to those in the array. Removing Equatable from car not only will make that stop working, but it will also trigger a series of errors and fixes that will eventually end up to adopting Equatable again. So, to recap, adopt the Equatable protocol to custom types if it's necessary to compare instances of them. Implementing the equal to operator is mandatory in classes and structs whose stored properties do not conform to Equatable already. Otherwise, it's synthesized automatically by the compiler. If you like this video, then check out my channel for more and subscribe so you get notified whenever a new one is published. You will see in the description a link to my website, where you can find a lot more programming content. Thank you for watching, take care, and enjoy coding!